Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. The I-130 family petition and the I-485 application for permanent residence can be sometimes filed together, sometimes they must be filed separately, and sometimes it might be advantageous to file them separately. And by the way, sometimes you can't even file the I-485 and some people make a mistake by trying to file it and they really mess up their immigration status, especially if they're here on some sort of tourist or non-immigrant visa. In this video, we're gonna be talking about when you should be filing these forms separately and when you should file them together or when you may file them together. If you're new to my channel, I'm Puyan Darian, an immigration attorney, and I'm here to talk about immigration law. One of the main reasons why I'm making this video is because I've seen people file their I-130 and I-485 separately when they could have filed them together and literally saved 2 years, gotten their permanent residence, and gotten on with their lives 2 years earlier than when they actually did. And aside from wasting time, it didn't, you know, destroy their lives or anything, but they would have benefited substantially had they seen this video. And before I go any further, I just want to say there's a lot more to this process than what I'm going to be describing. I'm just going to be going through a couple of the main highlights. So take what you will, but don't just watch this video and go and file your I-130 and I-485 forms without speaking with an immigration lawyer. If you're in the US and you're applying for a green card through a family petition, there are three categories of family petition where you might be eligible to adjust your status immediately in the US. The first one is marriage to a US citizen spouse. The second one is if you're the parent of a US citizen who is over age 21. And the third one is if you're a US citizen parent petitioning for a minor child who's in the US in some sort of status. You must have entered the US legally, as I'm sure you already know from watching my other videos. But if you're in the US and you want to apply for your green card with the family petition, you must be in one of these three categories, generally speaking. Now, you might not always want to file the green card application. Let's say you are visiting your spouse in the US on a tourist visa, and you have to go back to your home country because you have obligations. Let's say you have a government job and your contract is a few years longer, but you want to be able to visit your spouse or whatnot. And you want to be able to travel while the family petition is pending. In that situation specifically, you would only file the family petition. If you file the I-485 green card application, you've now indicated that you have immigrant intent. You're applying for permanent residence. You can no longer travel to the US as a tourist. So you'll have to wait in the US for however long it takes for that I-485 to get approved before you can leave the US again. There are some family petition categories where a visa may not be immediately available, and the classic one is a sibling petition. US citizen files a petition for their sibling who's abroad, and that process is going to take a minimum of 14 years, and if you're from certain countries, it'll take much longer than that. And let's say your sibling is visiting the US as a tourist, you can file the I-130, but if you file that I-485, first of all, it'll get denied because there's no visa available. Second of all, they've now shown immigrant intent and they might lose their tourist visa as a result of that. There are multiple reasons why that would be a huge mistake. But now let's take this a step further and say that it takes 14 years for that I-130 petition to become current and for a visa to become available for a sibling petition. So the sibling enters the US or doesn't matter. You file an I-130 for them. And while that I-130 is pending for 14 plus years or whatever, they continue to travel to the US and leave as a tourist. Now, let's say the visa is available. 14 years down the road, the visa is actually available and they enter the US as a tourist. And while they're here, they change their mind about their intent and they say like, hey, you know what? Actually, circumstances have changed. I'm in the US right now. A visa is available, Can I apply for adjustment of status in the US by filing my I-485 form now? The answer might be yes in that limited situation. The point is, this type of question, whether or not you should file your I-485 with the I-130 or the timing of it, is very fact specific. You need to speak with a lawyer, and the lawyer needs to explain it to you during a detailed consultation. It's not going to be just like a 5-minute conversation. There's a lot that we need to know before we can advise you on what the best strategy is for your life. To summarize, there are limited situations where you can and probably should file the I-130 and I-485 forms concurrently together. There are some situations where you absolutely cannot. And if you do file them together, you're going to be shooting yourself in the foot and creating way more problems for yourself. Even in a, you might not even be eligible to adjust your status in the future if you do something like that, if it's determined that you engaged in immigration fraud or you had fraudulent intent or something like that. If this is a situation that you're dealing with right now and you're not sure how to proceed, you should speak with an immigration lawyer. If you want to schedule a consultation directly with me, you can. My information is in the video description below. If you're confused after watching this video, then you're probably a pretty smart person, because this is really confusing and it means you're really thinking about it. Put your questions in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer all of them. And if there's a specific topic you want me to address, put it in the comments below and I'll discuss it in a future video. Thanks for watching my video, guys, and I'll see you next week for another one.